So we go way back to Gord's days. They started doing house concerts, and I've played every year they've done it for, I don't know, it's been 10 or 15 years. But I was wanting to do a virtual one originally, right after Memorial Day, because I was supposed to play June 6th at their place. Originally, this year's gig was on June 6th, so I thought, well, let's just still honor that, but we'll do a virtual thing, or we'll do a live stream from there, or something. And I talked to them, and they said they wanted to do an in-person show. It was different than it usually is. I mean, they changed a lot. Like, there used to be a big thing, hot dogs, you know, a big crock pot full of hot dogs you can serve yourself. They didn't do that anymore.
Yeah, and they said that sometimes there was like 300 people there.
Yeah, they would have huge crowds. I met through the Gourds. Amy was the first one I met. All the Gourds just kind of knew her. She's super cool. And then she became friends with our wives and our girlfriends. And, you know, Amy likes to cook. She's a really great cook, as you probably found out.
Yeah, that's the best part. I told them that that's one of the reasons we charge what we do. I was like, we charge more, but the food
is
part of the pay.
Yeah. So Amy really became a good friend. And Andrew, you know, of course, just as good a friend. But it really is about Amy. She's just an awesome person. And not taking anything away from Andrew. I don't want to play favorites here. But Andrew knows where I'm coming from. In normal times, there's usually a bunch of kids running around. They're all way, way out in the back of the yard. There was a Ford out there.
I think that Wildwood has a really deep, natural energy to it. Just the so fortunate that everything occurred like that. It seems It seems intelligent design.
It is. I think it has everything to do with Amy and Andrew and their community that's grown around them quite organically, for sure, you know. And it's a labor of love. They don't take any money from it. They just do it because they like music and they want to share music in their yard, and they have the ability, and they have a community around them who supports them.
Favorite story? Is there a favorite moment that you remember from all these years of playing at Wildwood?
Well, I mean, that, you know, that one we did, that frog. The frog was really great.
And I sent you that video, didn't I?
Yeah, I think you did. The frog has a name. Josephine, their daughter who lives there, she said the frog is like a member of the family. So it's funny, I didn't know that, but I could tell by the sound of the croak.
I
just want the people at home to be able to hear this toad frog. This toad frog is really
I'm beautiful. Recording it with my phone for
okay,
you.
Good. May somebody get his name, his number, his email,
his name,
maybe.
His name's Fred.
Hello, my baby. Hello, my daughter. Hello, my right
side. You know what I'm talking about. Okay.
Phineas J. Frog. Phineas J. Frog. That's
Phineas J. Frog.
weirdest version of Sweet Potato I've ever heard. And I'm really digging it. I hope I'll be able to recreate it.
First of all, for being my friends and for providing this venue for so many artists. I mean, so many of my friends in the community have benefited from their work there and what they've built. I mean, they really have built a community of music lovers and who support the arts at the most literal grassroots level. And I mean, they've made an impact on so many lives, and they probably don't even think about that, and they probably wouldn't even want to hear about it. That's the kind of people they are. They just do it because they love it. And but I'm truly grateful to have them in my life. Absolutely. And Wildwood, I'm glad it's gonna go on.
I mean, we do this for two reasons. One reason is we get to listen to music in our backyard, and we can drink as much as we want and not have to drive. And two, we do it for the artists. We do it to, you know, we give 100% of what we bring in to the artists. We don't keep any of it. It's not a money-making venture for us. It's a labor of love. And, you know, I mean, I hate that through this pandemic, we're paying the artists half of what we normally do. But I think it's still a great night.
You have to work in heaven. You're drunk, you're working up in heaven. Someone's got to build the roads. Someone's got to man the tools. Mother Mary, Jesus too, Washington and Martin Luther. Drinking and driving and working up in heaven. They don't have no DUIs in heaven. They don't have no state lines up in heaven. Driving like a bat out of hell up in heaven. Yes, everybody gets messed up, and everybody gets a sippy cup that always runneth over up in heaven.
We've been following Gardensmith for many, many years. And how many years ago? Five or six years ago. Finally, we're able to get him to come out to the Wildwood, and happy to say that he has wanted to come back every year. So this year, we did have to postpone his show, and we actually thought at some point it was going to be a year without Gardensmith. You know, we were able to get the shows going again, and we got him out here. So, without anything else, here's Garden Smith.
Yeah.
That's good. But, driving on I-10 out, you know, and going through, toward El Paso, all that, all the way to Arizona. When you drive west, you go by Van Horn, which is out there. Next time you're out there driving past Van Horn, look at those mountains over to the right, behind Van Horn, all the way to Sierra Blanca, which is the best name for a town, man, Sierra Blanca. I mean, you don't want to go to Sierra Blanca, but it's a cool name. Anyway, those mountains are called Sierra Diablo. I saw them on a map about 20 years ago, and I went, man, I'm going to write that song one of these days. I feel the wind blowing. Sierra Diablo. And I'm wondering if I could fly away on the wind blowing off of the Sierra Diablo. Just how far, how high, how long. Song in the telephone wire, train in the distance, the howl of a dog and the lovers in the room next door. Well, it all sent me tumbling forward back to your memory. How far, how high, how long did we fly? Well, I can't stop moving, but I don't know where to go. If I could only stand still, let the wind. Turn back the dust on Sierra Diablo. Turn back to rock, back to mountain, lava and sky. Well, we could be lovers like there was no tomorrow. How far, tell me just how long could we fly? Tell me how far, how high. Tell me how long, how long.
I've known Darden a long time. We did some co-writing together, you know, back in the about 10 years ago or so. It's always such a wonderful experience to watch him connect with the audience because he has a huge heart. It's just magnificent.
Yeah. I don't know that there's an easy story about how we got started. It really goes back to maybe even before our daughter was born, and she's 25. Well, something like that. When Amy was pregnant and we lived close to Flip Nautics, and she would walk down there for a Moonquake shake and watch whatever band was playing. And then after our daughter was born, we would take her for walks and end up at Flip Nautics and get to watch music. And through all of that, we got to know certain musicians, you know, became friends. So Amy, my lovely wife here, surprised me on my birthday by hiring a band to play in our backyard.
Mark Rubin and the Ridgetop Syncopators.
Yeah, one of my favorites. And it was phenomenal. It was everything we thought it would be. You know, we had a big pot of gumbo, a keg of beer, and and Mark Rubin on the deck. And we had about 100 of our friends come in from, come out to the country, as we called it back then, from in town. And we just had it, we had a swell time. It was great. And then I think, you know, 10:30 at night, Mark is wrapping it up. The gumbo's gone, that we floated the keg. I think we'd broken into the whiskey by then. And we're all sitting around saying, man, this is so much fun. But I mean, who's got this much money to hire a band every Saturday night? But, you know, we'd do it if we were rich. So we kind of thought that was it. It was a one-time gig. But then a few weeks later, we were at a friend's house. And she had been at the party, and they were having a little party, and we were telling her what a great time we had had. And she says, why don't you hire local, or why don't you invite local musicians to come out and play and just pass the tip jar to all your friends? And up until that point, I'd never heard of a house concert. I didn't know that they really even existed. And I said, well, you know, sure, but would artists really do that? And she says, well, you know, I will. And I was like, well, fantastic. What are you doing next weekend? And that's how we got our first gig.
And that was Noelle Hampton.
It was Noelle Hampton and Andre Moran.
So they were like some of our first good friends that we had, that we felt like, oh, this is family. So it was nice. That was a long time ago. It was like 16 years ago. They said, oh, we're going to move out of the neighborhood. We were like, no, because, you know, it was so great to see them. But they bought that beautiful property, and then they said, yeah, we envision having shows, and how would we do that? And would you guys be interested in doing that? And so we just did it as like a tester kind of a thing. And I remember, I think maybe there were like 20 people there or something. And there was a huge football game, UT game. We played that show. It was super fun, even though it was like kind of, you know, sparsely attended. I think we just brought our own PA and set up ourselves. And I think it was just Andre and myself as a duo. Can't exactly remember, but I imagine it was. And then we helped them, kind of connecting them with some of our other musician friends. And they already knew some of the musicians that they wanted to book, but they didn't have a PA. So we would go down every single time and bring our PA and set it up with Andrew, and kind of taught him how to do that. And it worked pretty well. I mean, they used our PA for a really long time. And I mean, I did sound for like John D. Graham there, and I did sound for a few different people, just because it was like, it was so easy. I was going to be there anyway to see the show. Inside of you, no skin off my back, I take you back from the bar.
Down on myself, cause I try, but what do you do? Pull me through. I'm humming, I'm coming to your town tonight.
Be kind, be kind to you, to be kind, be kind to you.
But they used to have hot dogs at every show. I don't know if they're still doing that. And they do s'mores for all the kids, and they would do hot dogs for the adults. And they paid for all of that themselves. It's their thing, and their generosity has no bounds. But it was such a family-friendly thing. That was the other thing, was there aren't a lot of places. There's some, but most kids kind of need to go to bed, or they need a place to run around. You can't really do an inside family-friendly show very well. So these guys knew how to just throw it down. The kids would be way out in the field playing, and there's nothing like it. Just thank you for giving people an opportunity to really be heard. One, be heard in such a spectacular setting, and to offer up an opportunity for artists to get paid so well that it could be a jump start. If you're on tour, it could take care of half your tour. If it's you know, if it's that you need to make a new recording or you're working on a video or something, that one show can really help you to just jumpstart the next thing that you need to do. It's not often that we can see that we're going to make this much money and go, okay, this is a huge opportunity to play catch up for all the money that we spend out as musicians. And I know they know that's important, and but I don't think they really realize how important it is to us. You know, I mean, they're just doing it out of generosity, but it's been such a leg up every time we've played there for us to get back on track financially. And that's a huge gift that they share their space. So thank you, Amy and Andrew. We love you guys. We think you're amazing humans. You crack us up. You're super fun to hang with. You make the best food ever. And your space will forever be in Austin, one of the best places to play forever.
Number called Overblown.
There's a cold wind blowing, blowing through my bones, far away from where it's meant to be. 'Cause unless it's snowing in the Rocky Mountain high, these bitter northern gusts can keep away from me. Overblown. Yeah, the winds, they missed their mark. They were traveling through the dark behind a storm.
It's just filthy. It's so filthy. Oh. But we can help. And one of the ways that we can help is we can help get rid of that nasty, germy, disgusting cash by accepting donations through Venmo or PayPal.
Mm-hmm. And this isn't a call to action. We just thought it was information you might want to know.
You get to do what you want to do with your money.
Well, if they wanted to do it, here's a convenient link right here. It's a link. It's a link. It's a link. It's a link right here. Here's a new song. Well, that's wonderful. And I guess you probably both just love music your whole lives, just fans.
Yeah.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
People are at their best when they're sharing the thing that they love. And you're a great example.
That is so true.
Here's another Austin great and itinerant folk musician making his living in exactly that same way. This is Matt the Electrician.
And the first time I also got to be at a Matt the Electrician show. So this has been a great for me.
So this one's for Ramona.
I feel like my wife knew Amy through some other friends of hers at some point, but I remember meeting them at Joe's Coffee on South Congress, and I think I was asked to come play a benefit for dogs or some sort of pet dog situation. And I remember that Amy was there and asked if I would ever be interested in playing a house concert, like a backyard concert. And I said, sure, of course. No. Shortly after that, they asked me to come play their series, but it was the first year that they did it, I believe.
You were the third artist that they had do a social distance style show for. And it's very different than the usual scene, I'm learning.
The Wildwood situation is it's a pretty massive backyard. And in regular times, there's anywhere between 200 and 300 people. they technically cap it at, I think, 250, two or 250, but with kids and everything else, sometimes it gets up closer to 300. So, you know, there's usually a lot of people. It's very interactive. The kids are always running around the back part of the property playing games and whatnot. And you know, the big difference is just after the show, you know, I didn't go over and really talk to a lot of people, and people weren't standing around waiting to talk to me. So, and as long as I've been doing it, my family's been coming along. I don't think they came to the first 2 years, maybe, but after that, my wife or kids or some version thereof was always at the shows.
So feel free to sing along with this one in your head, and I know that all that intro, now this song is going to feel very depressing. So I apologize for that. I didn't really think through the segue before I did it. Slip sliding away, slip sliding away. You know the nearer your destination, the more you slip sliding away. I know a man, he came from my hometown. He wore his passion for his woman like a thorny crown. He said, Dolores, I live in fear. My love for you so overpowering, I'm afraid that I might disappear. Slip sliding away, slip sliding away. You know the nearer your destination, the more you slip sliding away. I knew a woman, became a wife. They're the very words she uses to describe her life. Whoops. She says, a good day ain't got no rain. She said, a bad day's when I lay in bed and think about things that I might have been. Slip sliding away. Slip sliding away. The nearer your destination, the more you slip sliding away. I knew a father who had a son. He longed to tell him all the reasons for the things he'd done. He drove a long way just to explain. He kissed his boy as he lay sleeping, and then he turned around and he headed home again. Slip sliding away, slip sliding away. You know the nearer your destination, the more you slip sliding away. God only knows, God makes his plans. The information's unavailable to the mortal man. We work our jobs, collect our pay. Believe we're flying down the highway when in fact we're slip sliding away. Slip sliding away. Slip sliding away. You know the nearer your destination, the more you slip sliding away. Maybe if we like whisper swing, sing it together, I think that might be the safest way. And I'll just kind of stop playing, but we'll like whisper sing it. You guys ready? We're gonna do it. Here we go. Like no projection. We're not gonna spit on our neighbors. None of that. Okay. Here we go. Slip sliding away. Slip sliding away. You know, the nearer your destination, the more you slip sliding away. I didn't get it till the end, so let's do it again, because I was like yelling at the beginning, and then I realized that was setting the wrong example for you. So we'll really all try to whisper sing it, but I have a microphone. Okay, you ready? Here we go. Two, three, boom, boom. Slip sliding away. Slip sliding away. You know, the nearer your destination, the more you slip sliding away. Thank you guys again very much. Thanks for coming. Thank you to Amy and Andrew.
My favorite things about the Wildwood, and even as I say it, I'm thinking of more favorite things. Amy always makes food for the musicians. She always makes just the best, like chili or pozole or some kind of like big stew soup thing that we all kind of go in and eat. So grateful to Amy and Andrew for opening up their home and their yard to us lucky Austin musicians that get to play their series. Because not only is it just a really enjoyable, it's just a really enjoyable event, and there's so much great fan interaction and the crowd that you get to know over the years. But also financially, it's one of the better shows I play every year. They take care of the musicians really well, and you know, that's says something about Amy and Andrew and the audience that they bring out there.
And Matt the Electrician is always one of our most popular shows every year, and Matt has played every year since we started this. And we just adore him. Like, his shows are just so intimate and personal and fun, and our people love him. So it's we've been a family friendly venue from the beginning. We encourage people to bring their children. We don't ask for a donation from children. We don't expect one. Like, even your teenage kid, they're coming because you're bringing them. Right. You know, so
they willingly expose themselves to live music.
That's right.
So it makes it affordable for a family to be able to come out. Yeah. You know, they can bring their own picnic and they can, you know, sit in the yard. And normally when it's a much bigger show, the whole back acre of the yard becomes just a huge kind of Lord of the Flies situation.
The surprise engagement at the very end of a show, where I was beginning to break down the sound up on stage, and I look down and I see this guy, and he was a fairly regular there with his date, who'd also been a fairly regular, and he's down on one knee, and I was trying to figure out what they were doing from a distance, and I realized that they were getting engaged, and that was really sweet. You know, he said that one of their first dates had been at the Wildwood, like this was like their first date, let's go to the Wildwood, and she didn't really know what to expect, you know, driving out this little country road with a guy that she didn't really know all that well, and
red flags.
And so they felt like that was the right place to get engaged. I think that's probably the coolest thing that's happened.
But you know, in this time of the great pandemic, it's made me like really quite, you know, like sort of question, like, you know, what's the point? And you do these live stream concerts. One of the great things about doing this, like, there's actually people here, but you do live stream concerts, you just have to believe that there's somebody out there. You never know until the end of the show, and you look at it and go, oh, wow, there was somebody listening, because you can't, it's quiet. You finish a song, it's quiet. That's really strange. It's taken a lot of time to get used to it. Now I really love it. But you know, you never know. And as this, you know, somebody who writes songs, you sing these songs, you never know. Somebody's sitting on the other side of the country, the other side of the world, whatever, they hear these songs. It's really...
We don't take donations for us. You know, we ask that if you really want to donate to an artist, go buy some of their music, you know, own the CD or download the music. We do have a webpage, wildwoodshows.com, and Wildwood is spelled W-Y-L-D-W-O-O-D shows.com, all one word. And from there, we talk about our venue. You can look at a calendar and see what's coming up. But from there, it does sort of become a word of mouth thing. We don't maintain a big email list. We're actually, and I don't mean to break my own arm patting ourselves on the back, but we're actually quite popular, and it's easy to have the crowd get out of control. So typically what we'll do is 2 weeks before a show, now this is pre-COVID, 2 weeks before a show, we would post on our webpage a place where you could submit and ask for an invitation. And we would take the first, you know, X number of people. After we had looked at all of our regulars that were coming that had guaranteed reservations already, we would go through first come, first serve and hand out invitations to the remaining people to fill our yard, you know, with 225 people or so.
I'm sure you're worried about your favorite artist during this lockdown because live performance is the wrong thing to be doing. Live performance, singing, is droplet spreading. And I'm a pretty...
you're a spit spewer.
I'm a droplet fountain. That's what I do. But you can support the artists that you love through this difficult time through platforms like Patreon. Patreon is a website that allows you to subscribe to your favorite artists so that they can continue to eat regularly and continue to produce the music that you love.
It also helps them. Right now during the pandemic, I think most artists are using the Patreon just to exist, which is a beautiful thing. And then once we start coming out of the pandemic, mm-hmm. that money will be allocated for recording.
Yeah, and we can record the songs that we've been writing.
And we've been writing a lot of songs. Ooh. Let's show him the snake song that you just did.
Right.
Yeah. So this is a song that Guy just wrote. He's been kind of tinkering it for a while from what I've gathered. Mm-hmm. And then Nevada, who's also in the video, he lives out in the country where there's lots of scorpions in the summer. So during the pandemic, we all enjoyed watching Nevada, which Nevada probably didn't enjoy it. But Nevada was being just pelted, attacked by these scorpions all summer.
Pelted with scorpions.
Like, well, falling from a ceiling and everything.
Which is just something we do here in Texas. Yeah,
it's true. So this song spells it out for you. So here you go. This is Snakes by my husband.
Thank you.
Of all the sadness and the joy love can bring, and the darkness gathers all around us, mixed with the sound of the ocean.
We found our way the best we can. Now here we are, 20 toes in the sand, arm in arm, side by side, sun going down with the tide, while the frogs and the crickets sing, of all the sadness and the joy love can bring, and the darkness gathers all around us, mixed with the sound of the ocean. Black sky and the echoes of our footsteps, the warm night air carries us this song, and our hearts can't help singing along while the frogs and the crickets sing of all the sadness and the joy love can bring, and the dark with the sound. frogs and the crickets sing. Of all the sadness and the joy love can bring. And the darkness gathers all around us, mixed with the sound of
mentioned earlier, you know, we were talking about being kid friendly. When you think about the fact that we've been doing this for 15 years, there are couples that come to our shows with three kids that didn't have any kids when they came to our first show. Mm-hmm. And those kids are now, you know, 7, 8, 9 years old. And they've always known Wildwood as a place that they go in the summertime. And that to me is one of the, that's really sweet to me to think that to them, this is just what normal summertime activities are like, going to run around in a big backyard and listen to live music off in the distance. So I wanted to throw that in there because that's one of my favorite things about hosting all of this.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's beautiful.
And what's yours, Amy? What's your favorite?
So I'm going to agree with Andrew. It's the fact that we've watched these families, like from the start, these couples that started coming when they were first married or when they had their first baby, and then the next year they come back and boom, they have another baby, and watching these kids grow up, you know, like these little kids that when they first came to a Wildwood show, they were in arms. They were like an infant in their mother's arms or father's arms. And then as they keep coming, all of a sudden, you know, they're 7-year-olds and they're 9-year-olds, and you watch them grow and you realize that these kids are, they do have these memories of Wildwood being like, so in the summertime, we used to go to this big backyard, and, you know, they have these memories, and that we've created that community, that sense of place.
I think that's it. I just want to go back.
Yeah, I do too. do you guys?
We'd like you to come back as musicians.
I feel like that's what I proposed to. Look, I turned all red.
Yes, we'd love to do it. We'd be very excited, very honored.
I'd like to thank my mom and our agent, KT. That'd be fun.
Get in touch about 2021. I mean,
yeah, we'll make
it
that happen.
It has to happen. Like sitting and listening to you guys at my kitchen table was just,
just
chilling. Fantastic. Yeah.
There are snakes around my trailer. I found a scorpion in my bed. Found a scorpion in my bed. If Texas has its way, there will be bloodshed.
Thanks, Bridget Caitlin.
Black mold underneath the sheetrock. Paper wasps in the eaves. I try to keep up with the upkeep, but an honest man may be deceived. Upon by thieves. Oh, it's a jacked up day where you wake up and you're already late. Open out the front door, wonder what I run for to meet my fate. If Texas had its way, I'd be gone without a trace. 100 right behind me to take my place. Thank you.
Bid you adieu. I'll send you a text, Amy.
Great. Thank you guys so much for this.
Thanks.
Fun.
This is fun.
Yeah.
All right.
We'll see you soon, I hope.
Wildwood. The same boat.